should remain in the center. This is the bubble. It should remain in the center. For all 360 degree rotation, if the bubble remains at the center, the vertical axis is truly vertical. Vertical axis truly vertical. The vertical axis is truly vertical. Okay. The vertical axis is truly vertical. Now, before setting an instrument, you should know what are the temporary adjustments. How do you do a temporary adjustment? Temporary adjustment. When you set your instrument at a place like this, okay, you got a tripod. So you have got an instrument over here. The bar, this is your line of collimation, and this is what is called your vertical axis. When the bubble remains at the center for all 360 degree rotation of the instrument, we say that the vertical axis is truly vertical. Vertical axis is truly vertical. Vertical axis is truly vertical. So what is that we do? When you set your instrument, there will be, this is a plan view. This is a plan view. So what you do is these are the foot screws which have been provided at the bottom of it, foot screws. So you place your instrument in the parallel to the line joining these two foot screws like. So you will be moving inward. So you'll be moving like this. So you'll be moving this way or this way. This way or this way. So you will be moving inward or outward these two screws, and you bring the bubble to the center. Is that okay? Is that okay? First instance, listen it carefully in the book. If you, even the book, if it is explained, it will not be explained properly. You will not understand. If you got any doubt, you can ask here in question. Any doubt? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Now you are moving the first instant, you are placing the bubble tube over the line joining these two points. So move the foot screw inward or outward and bring the bubble to the center. Then what you do is, so I named the foot screw as let me name this as 1, this as 2, and this as 3. So first instance 1 and 2, then you keep your telescope over the third foot screw. You are operating the foot screw this way or that way and bring the bubble to the center. Okay, bubble to the center. Then rotate it for all 360 degree rotation. If the bubble remain at the center for all 360 degree rotation, then you say that the vertical axis is truly vertical. Did you get the point? Okay. So first you place the instrument over this, move the this thing inward or outward, and bring the bubble to the center and place it over the third foot screw, operate the third foot screw and bring the bubble to the center so that the bubble remain at the center for all 360 degree rotation of the telescope. Then you say that the vertical axis is truly vertical. If the bubble has deviated, so first you do it, you place the telescope over 1 and 2, this position, bring the bubble to the center and place it over the third screw perpendicular to the earlier setup. Move the third screw and bring the bubble to the center. Rotate the telescope by 180 degree. Okay. The telescope is like that. You're rotating it, make it to 180 degree like this. So you are rotating it about telescope. This is the telescope. So this is vertical axis. It rotate about the vertical axis. You make the telescope rotate it by 180 degree. Is okay? Right. Note down the deviation, because the normally you will have your bubble tube is be like this. So it has got a bubble, then some graduations will be there, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that on either side. So the bubble is supposed to remain at the center. Suppose it has deviated by 2n division. Kindly note it. If it has deviated by 2n division, suppose it has deviated by 4 division, n equal to the bubble has deviated by 2n division, the bubble has gone this way rather than remaining at the center. It has moved by 2n division. Suppose it has moved by 4 division, it is out of center by 4 division. What is n?
2.
Simple mathematics. I'm not asking a very difficult question. Simple mathematics. So suppose it has deviated by 2n division. N division, n is equal to the total division divided by 2. Okay. After that, is okay for you?
Yes, sir.
So what is that as shown here is the arrangement of the bubble tube. So this is the body of the telescope. What is that I shown here is the body of the telescope. This is the body of the telescope. Okay, body of the telescope over which the bubble is being attached. Now one part of it is fixed actually. The bubble, the one part of it is fixed. The other part of it is got a screw and then nut arrangement. So the entire bubble tube can go up or come down. So these screws are called caption headed screw. These screws are called caption headed screw. Okay. So when you loosen this nut, you're able to see that when you loosen this nut here, lower it down and tighten it, this bubble tube will come down. Or when you loosen this knob, this knob up, this bubble can go up or down. When you go up or down, what will happen? When it comes down, the bubble will move this side. When it comes up, the bubble will move this side. As long. So this you cannot touch it normally. So what is that you have done? First instant, you have placed the bubble tube parallel to the two and perpendicular arrangement, and used the third foot screw, brought the bubble to the center. Then rotate it by 180 degree. Find out how many divisions this way or this way the bubble has moved. Note it as 2n division. N division you adjust it by captain headed screw. N division you adjust by the captain headed screw. The remaining N division you adjust it with the third foot screw. Is that okay? I'll repeat that. First you are placing the telescope this way, connecting these two foot screw. Bring the bubble to the center, bubble remaining at the center like this. The bubble remains at the center. Now what I do, I just keep it over this way. The bubble is not out of center. Use the third foot screw and bring the bubble to the center. Then I move it 180 degree. Note down if the bubble remain at the center, then this thing is truly vertical. Okay. If the bubble remain at the center, the instrument is truly vertical. Then use a captain headed screw and bring the end division by adjusting the captain headed screw. Remaining end division by what is called the third foot screw. So you have to do the adjustment for all 360 degree rotation. The bubble remain at the center, then the vertical axis is truly vertical. It's okay, right? It's okay now, right? Now I have a level like this level. Okay, now this is my, what is it? This is my horizontal line of sight actually, right? Now bubble remain at the center. Your line of collimation is inclined by an angle alpha. The line of collimation is inclined by an angle alpha. Okay. Now at D1 from one place, I'm holding a leveling staff. Now this is the leveling staff. Right. Now this value should be, say this is A, this is B. So this is B HA and this is HB. Right. Now the line of sight is inclined by alpha. So what is the reading? You will get it in A, you will get a reading in. So let me put this as D2. Right. So this is what is called error A. This is what is called error B. What is EA? What is EA? E sufficient in terms of alpha. EA is equal to
tan alpha D1.
D1 tan alpha. Am I right? Okay. EB equal to D2 tan alpha. Am I right? Is it okay for you? EA equal to D1. Tan alpha, this is D2 tan alpha. I would like to know what is the correct reading, na? right? So this is your correct reading. HA difference HB is a true value. HA difference this thing is a true value. So let me put this as capital HA and this is as capital HB. So HA minus D1 tan alpha equal difference HB minus D2 tan alpha equal to true elevation difference. Am I right? This is difference, okay. So HA, this HA minus D1 tan alpha difference HB minus D2 tan alpha equal to true elevation difference. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Right. So HA difference HB true difference is the error is if you take it D1 tan alpha minus D2 tan alpha, the whole error, the difference. Suppose D1 equal to D2. D1 equal to D2.
The HA difference HB is the
whatever reading, error get. Suppose D1 equal to D2, what happens? EA and EB cancel out, no? D tan alpha, D tan alpha. These two go out, HA difference HB is equal to true difference. Even though you are reading it erroneously, okay? Even though you are reading erroneously, you will be able to find out what is the true difference in elevation. Correct or not? This is what is called the balancing of sight. This is what is called the balancing of sight. If you remember this principle, I can proceed further. When you set, what is the condition? When you set your instrument exactly in between two points, whatever reading is there, the error gets nullified. After all, you have to find out without the error. Okay, error get nullified. Is it okay? Right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, what I do is, I have an instrument which has got a error. I don't know what is a error in that. So what I do is, I select two point A and B. And set my instrument. I select a two point A and B and set my instrument over here, exactly middle point of that. So I got a point A and I got a point B, exactly in the middle. And then I observe a staff reading over here. Okay. So I put it as HA, HB. Okay. HA difference HB is equal to what?
Total error.
So the distance, let me put this as a capital D. So this is D by 2 and this is D by 2. Okay. Listen it carefully. That's not explained properly in any of the textbooks. So HA difference HB is True difference in elevation. Am I right? True difference in elevation. Okay. First point, what I do? I keep the instrument in the center of it. I observe the point level at HA and HB with an erroneous instrument. Line of sight is inclined, I don't know. Okay, the line of sight when the bubble remain at the center, it should generate a horizontal plane against which you place a scale and take a reading, right? If the line of sight is not perpendicular to the vertical axis, that it generates a problem of a cone actually. Then comes the error. Then that has to be corrected. So when I set the instrument at the center and take a reading against the chalk at the 2 points, when the instrument is at the center, the error gets nullified. Suppose this is 100 meter A and B, 100 meter, okay. Then I take a reading, find out what is this. So HA difference, HB is a true difference in elevation. This is the first step. Second step is, what I do is, I sense the instrument very close to A, very close to A, right? So this is the midpoint, this is your A, your point A, and this is your point B. So you got a line of sight like this. So I have this, I have this. So originally HA difference HB is equal to true difference. True difference. Okay. Now let me read this value as some HA dash and HB dash. Is that visible to you? And the instrument is at a point D, D, D. So this is capital D. This is capital D. And this is a small d. Okay. So suppose this is 100 meter, at a 10 meter from this I take a reading. So the I have HA dash and then I have HB dash. Is that clear to you up to this? You have to respond by other way. I find it difficult. Somebody.
Yes, sir.
First instance, I am keeping the instrument at the center. I am reading it, finding out the true difference of it. Now, what I should find out is, assuming HA dash is, because very close to the HA dash is correct, what is the value of HB dash? Some value should be there. So what is that? The value at B should be HA dash, assuming that HA dash, plus or minus elevation difference. Plus or minus elevation difference is what is called HA double dash. Okay. When you use a plus, if it is a fall, you use a plus. If it is a rise, you use a minus. They get it. Sorry, this should be elevation difference. This is equal to HB1. I put it HB1. Whatever it is, don't worry. Okay. Assuming that HA dash is right, plus or minus elevation difference is HB1. Okay? Is it okay? Assuming HA dash is correct. Compare HB1 and HB dash. HB1 and HB dash is what is called the error. HB1 and HB dash is the error E. Okay. The error E. So I have to find out the correction. Correction at A equal to E into D by D. Correction at A. Correction at B equal to E into D plus D by D. D plus D and D. So I repeat again the whole procedure. I have written the procedure. That this is visible to you. I'll write it legibly. E D by D equal to E D plus D by D. Okay. D. Now what I'll do, what I have done is I take the instrument at the center, observe the top reading at A and B, find out the difference, set a difference, HB is a true difference in elevation. Suppose I keep the first point at center, I am reading A as 1 meter, B as 2 meter. A as 1 meter, B as 2 meter. Okay. Now, what is the true difference in elevation? 1 meter. HI is at a height and HB is at a lower level, 1 meter below that. Is it okay? 1 meter and 2 meter, the true difference in elevation is 2 minus 1 is 1 meter. Now what I did, I have kept the instrument at the point D, small d, very close to A. I observe HI dash and HB dash. Suppose this is 0.805 and this is 1.815. Okay? 1.815. So that is the reading at HA dash and HB dash. 0.805 is HA dash, 0.815 is HB dash. So I compare, so what is that? HA is right there. What I should, HB1 should be 0.805 plus 1.805, but it is 1.815. So line of sight is inclined upward or downward. It should have been 1.815, but it is 1.815. It is 1.815. So line of sight is inclined upward. So 1.815 and 1.805, the error is 0.010. That is the total error. This E is the 1.010. So correction at A is equal to E. E is 0.010 into 10 by 100. B, 0.010 into 110 by 10. Okay. So now the line of sight is inclined upward. You have to bring down the line of sight. I'll tell you how to do that. Shall we work out a numerical problem? Is it clear to you? So I kept the instrument at the center. I observed the value of 1.00 and 2.00 meter. D equal to 100 meter. So I kept the instrument at the center and then I value it. So this is A and this is B. This is 50 meter. this is 50 meter, this is 1 and this is 2. You are okay at A and B. Okay. Right. Because you have to work out the problem. So what is the true difference in elevation now? What is the true difference in elevation now? What is the true difference in elevation?
1 meter.
1 meter. So true difference in elevation is? True difference in elevation equal to 1 meter. Now what I do is I kept the instrument at near to A. I have read the stuff. So what is this value? Can I give you? Now this is 0.395. So 1.375. Okay. I kept the instrument at very close to A. This is A and this is B. So this is your line of sight. Is it okay? Fine. The value is 1.375. B, it is 1.375. Okay. So assuming that A is right, A is right. So the next value is 0.395, 1.375, net setup. And D is equal to 10 meter. The D, small d is equal to, small d equal to 10 meter. So 395 is correct, 0.395 plus 1. Is that not true difference? The value should be 1.395. But what is the value? What is the value? 1.375. The value is 1.395, but the value is 1.395. What is the error? Error is 1.395, 1.375. How much is the error? 0.020 meter. If you are clear up to this, I can proceed further. Is it okay, boy? Right? Error is 0.020 meter. It should have been 1.395, but it is 1.375. What that means? The line of sight is inclined downward. Line of sight is inclined downward. How do I get 1.395? How do I get 1.395? Because I had assuming that A is right. I find out what should be the reading at B. So I have added the true elevation. It should have been 1.395, but it is 1.375 because the instrument is erroneous. So error is 0.020, inclined downward. That you should write, inclined downward. So what is the correction at A? Correction at A is, correction at A is, correction at A equal to 0.020 into 10 by 100, D by capital D. So how much is that? Calculate and tell me, somebody.
0.002.
0.002 meter. Correction at B equal to 0.020 into 10 plus 100 divided by 100, how much is that?
0.022.
0.022. 110 by 100 na into 11 by 10, 0.0020 into 11, 22, 0.022, 0.022, correct? Meter.
Yes, sir.
Correct. So not two is not possible. Correct it as 0.005 meter, because the level top has got a least count of points, so you have to correct it to next decimal. So here it is 0.025 meter. So what is the correct reading at A? Correct reading at A equal to, what is the reading? 0.0395 minus 0.005 is equal to 0.390. Am I right? You should add, la, because 1.375 inclined upward, so you start to bring down. So right, 0.395 minus 1.375. What is the value given? 1.375. So 1.375 is lower. 1.375 should have been 0.02. So you should add plus. So it is 0.400 meter. Correct reading at B equal to 1.375 plus 0.025. How much is that? It is 1.400 meter. What is the corrected value? 0.4 and 1.4, true difference is 1 meter. So what we do is, so look at the figure here. So nothing like a cross, you'll have what you call a diaphragm, wherein you will have a etching. So a lens with that etching like this, okay? So in the lens, it will be like this, no? So you have a lens. So the small groove will be there. Small, the crosser, okay? This is a crosser. Normally what you do is you polish it. The graphite powder will be applied over there. In the lens itself, you will have a marking, a small groove cut. And you have got a screw. When you open out your eyepiece, you can see this diaphragm. This, you can move it. You have got a screw over here. This is, you have got a screw over here. When you loosen the screw and tighten it, this entire setup will move up and down. Now, no book will read this, because I have done it personally myself. I'm telling you. So what you do is, at A, when you have kept that, you have to adjust it and see that your staff reading is 0.400 meter. Then holding the staff at B, find out whether you are getting 1.400 meter. That way you say that you have done a permanent adjustment for the level. Okay, so this is how we make the permanent adjustment. One is adjustment for the level tube. The other thing is adjustment for a line of sight. If you take a book and read this, you will not understand. This is the way how you do the your adjustment for line of collimation. So we have got what is called a temporary adjustment and what is called a permanent adjustment. This is the way how you do a permanent adjustment. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Sir, regarding the CT corrections, can students ask now?
Pardon?
Sir, regarding the CT's corrections, can students
how long
ask
you,
now?
Oh, yeah, yesterday I told you that this is the scheme evaluation.
Okay, sir.
So, see, if you risk yourself, why don't you come tomorrow? Tomorrow, do you have a CT test?
Two tests or one test? Sir, you asking? Tomorrow, do you have a cycle test? Sir, no, sir, got over by yesterday. Today itself it's over. Yeah, yeah. Tomorrow, what I suggest is what time? Yeah, 12:30 class. 12:30. So we'll afternoon, you people are free? Sir, no, sir, actually afternoon we have classes. What time? At 3 o'clock, sir. Till 3 o'clock? No, sir, from I think 2:30 to 4 will be.
2:30 to 4, okay. Shall we have a Viva for the entire batch starting from 4 o'clock? We'll go up to whatever your answer book, you just come on, and then whoever has got this thing, you will ask a Viva. And then, see, I have normalized it again and again. If you have got, if I have not valued it, somehow if it is by mistake, a very rare case, I'm ready to do it. But tomorrow, 4 o'clock, we'll meet. One by one, you can come online. But you have to come on a video mode. Ready? I'm ready to spend you 2 hours even. Okay? Tomorrow, we don't have then 12:30 class. Do you have a 12:30 class?
Yes, sir. Tomorrow, we have.
Okay. 12:30 class, it is a tutorial. I will give you a problem, you have to work out and then submit it.
Zero.
Okay, right.
So sir, tomorrow one boy, he got zero actually because of changing the order, is it?
No. See, I tell you, after 4 days he has uploaded that. Yesterday he spoke to me. I told him that I will give you a question paper on Saturday. You have to take it up. Because either I should be wrong or he should be wrong. I don't want to risk myself actually.
Okay,
right, the system for everybody it shows correct one. Even you people after half an hour and other thing you have done it. That's very bad on your part. Now for everything, for one mark you are asking me. Like, but what about this? Anyway, from next class, this thing onwards there will be very big and hard.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
1 minute. Hello? Ah, sir. Or class le irukke. The mudichittu pesuren. All right. Ah.
Sir.
So what?
Sir, I submitted the exam on time also, but you have not given me marks from 1 to 8. You said it is not in order.
Yeah. Which one?
Sir, row number 75.
Whatever it is. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, I have written the correct answer. You said the answer also. I matched it. But you have not given me marks.
Hey, in your open forum, you cannot blame a teacher like that. That's why I told you by 4 o'clock. What nonsense you are talking, boy. You are not valid.
No,
what is it? Huh? Don't say like that. One day, you say that why you are not valid. I'm not your servant. Ready. Think of it.
Sir, sorry for that. I am not. My mean was not that.
There is a way of doing it. In an open forum. That is why I protected your interest. It has been given in assignment. You talk to me private by 4 o'clock. In an open class, you should not do that.
Okay, sir. Sorry.
Okay. Okay.
So thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.